Now that you've had a chance to watch a video with some standing waves, let's take a look at the standing wave parameters that are important. The picture shown here in figure 2.11 from your book are the envelopes of the standing wave. From the very last video, the last one that you looked at, it actually drew the magnitude of the standing wave, and the wave itself was bouncing around up and down underneath this envelope. The envelope is what we're going to be talking about now. The envelope has a maximum value that we're going to call Vmax, and it has a minimum value right here that we're going to call Vmin. So this is not the minimum of the time domain waveform, but this is the largest amplitude that the time domain reaches any place on the line. Vmin is the minimum value that the time domain waveform reaches any place on the line. So we're going to use these two values, Vmin and Vmax. There's something called a standing wave ratio, and sometimes it's called a voltage standing wave ratio. So it's either SWR or VWR. And that is going to tell us the Vmax divided by the Vmin. Both of these are in magnitude. Now, this is also equal to, there's a derivation I think in your book, it's 1 plus the reflection coefficient over 1 minus the reflection coefficient. It is this value divided by that value. So in this picture, the voltage standing wave ratio is going to be about 1.3. That's Vmax, divided by about 0.7, so it's not quite 2. Vmax divided by Vmin is the standing wave ratio, or the voltage standing wave ratio, and it is also related to the reflection coefficient. So as soon as we find VSWR, we can use that to calculate the reflection coefficient. This is a very important capability. We can't measure the reflection coefficient directly in most cases, but we can measure the VSWR, and we use that in order to calculate the reflection coefficient. Now let's take a look at these two plots, the one on the top and the one on the bottom. One is the voltage reflection, is the plot of the envelope of the standing wave of the voltage. The other one is the envelope of the standing wave of the current. What do you notice about them? Notice that the peak of the voltage corresponds to the minimum of the current, and the minimum of the voltage corresponds to the maximum of the current. So this is Imax. That's in the same place as Vmin, and that Imin is in the same place as Vmax.